Hey guys, it's Charli. So I disappeared again, but at least I'm being consistent with my disappearances, and consistency is key. No, it's not. But I'm going to warm up to my Halloween kind of makeup looks with this green, and it is the second episode of my Crayola series. I am super, super excited to show you guys how I did this because I went in not having any idea. I'm super happy with this. So it's kind of like a glammed up zombie. Like, I'm using the term zombie very loosely. Like, this is a standard Charli look with eyelashes and a little bit of paint, but... I am so sorry about disappearing. I'll be back more frequently, and I'm honestly just going to let you guys watch this because I'm super keen to show you. So let's get right on with it. Hello, I'm back. I'm just really bad at consistently like filming and uploading stuff. I don't know what else you'd expect, but like, okay, so today I'm going to be doing green. I'm not too sure what I'm going to be doing, but I have kind of like an idea. I want to be like a zombie. So let's just see where that goes. First, I'm going to do a base and all that fun stuff. I'm just going to be using my new foundation, which is the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk in the shade 2, which is the lightest because I'm allergic to my Too Faced foundation. I just found that out, so that's always something fun to like realize. So I'm going to be applying it with this Morphe brush. I don't know what it is. I only just started putting foundation on with a brush, and I'm just like, what a concept. So getting it on with a brush, and then going in with a sponge, I think is the best method for putting on foundation now. I've been converted because then you can get the foundation all nice on your face without it soaking into a sponge, and then you can blend it out and have all the free reign to do that. So I just put like, I don't know what a pump is because I'm dumb. I'm going to blend this out with a dry beauty blender. Actually, I'm gonna spray some, I have some Urban Decay All Nighter, so I might spray it with that. Because I'm too lazy to go there and get my Mario Badescu. I hate doing that because it gets all like watery and it doesn't exactly soak up into the new blender, but I mean, it's whatever. And my hair's getting in the way. Great. I'm going to go on to concealer, and I'm going to be using trusty old Makeup Forever Ultra HD because this is my life. I'm genuinely running out of it, and I've never run out of products before except for eyeliner, so I mean, I'm absolutely shook about that. But I'm going to be putting that on. Okay, no, that brush is dirty. Never mind. I'm just going to put it on with my fingers. I'm going to pop it on Zitney Spears here because, like, don't worry. And then I'm going to blend it again. Look at this lovely little egg that it's got now because I sprayed it with the pretty setting spray. I'm going to blend it with the eggy part because it's the most wet part. This is like life hacks for lazy people. I'm actually going to leave a little bit of my dark circles so I'm not going to completely, like, heavy duty conceal them. But yeah, this is a kind of, ooh, spooky mark. It's a spook mark. So, you know, glam, green zombie. Like, I don't know, might end up turning into like poison ivy or something later on, but you never know with me. It's a bag. Okay, so I'm going to go in with this Makeup Forever palette, and I'm going to actually do like dark circles, and I'm going to do really slight contouring with green. I don't know how this is going to work, so I'm hoping for the best. Do I spray this? I don't know, I'm really bad at using this. I use it a lot for stage makeup. Like, I use it for drama and for films. I'm going to take this little pink one and I'm going to dab it into the green, and I'm just going to tap that under my eyes. I'm going to end up looking like the Wicked Witch of the West at the end of this. Or like Shrek. Get you a girl that can do both. I actually like this when it's wet. A lot easier to apply. My goal is to look like sick. So I mean, I'm getting there. And I'm going to put a little bit here as well. And then blend it with the little butt of the beauty blender. I literally want to look like I'm decomposing, so I mean, like... I'm going to take a little bit of the red as well and put it, like, in my nose area, and the blue as well. So I'm going to try to do, like, a little bit of this with green, and I'm just going to dot it a little bit around areas where, you know, your face would, like, decompose. Oh, I don't think that's working out. Actually, I don't mind that, because it's not too green. I blend it. Oh, I dropped my beauty blender.
Life is so hard.
Why do bad things happen to good people? Okay, gonna continue. Okay, I'm gonna put the green here in my nose as well. Cause you know, that's how you look like you're a little bit dead. You know, you gotta be. I love how I make such deprecating jokes, but like they're all pass for help. I'm gonna go in with the blue here a little bit, so this dark blue, and kind of like press that right there. Oh, I made it very, very, very blue. Okay, I'm gonna take brown. I'm gonna try very lightly with the freaking brown because this happens. And I'm gonna take the red on my finger and literally just go like this. Cool, great, that's my cream face. Pretty much done and dusted. But I really like that makeup from paint. I don't use it as much as I should. And I love. Okay, I'm gonna do my eyebrows now. Anastasia Brow Express. Don't want to watch that, it's really boring, so I'll catch you later. Okay, so my eyebrows are done. They don't look remotely good, but it's whatever. I'm going to set my face with my Kat Von D Locket Powder. I keep leaving all my face stuff over there accidentally. I take my Morphe setting brush, and I'm going to do my least favorite thing in the world, which is tap in excess. It just gives me, like, asthma. And I'm going to set my face with that. What? I don't know why I put that up my nose. My eyes are watering now. Heck. Okay, I'm alright. That was painless. But I'm going to move on to my eyes now. I'll move on to the rest of my face, like if I want to try and use other shades to contour with. I'm going to do that later, but I'm going to move on to my eyes now. I actually only have one green eyeshadow, which is this Colour Gloom from the Kat Von D Pastel Goth Palette. I'll try to swatch it on this hand right here. Okay, I think I can work with that. But I also have one of these two bad boys to use as a liquid liner. So hopefully that will like save me. I think I'm going to take a big old Morphe brush, and I'm just going to pack the green gloom onto my eyes and all around them. Forgot to put an eye base on, but I mean like it's whatever. Oh, that's really blue based. Okay, we'll work with that. That's a very blue based green. Okay, that's fine. That's all good. That's way more blue than it. I'm confused. Okay, so after I've packed that, I'm going to just blend it out super quick with my Bare Minerals brush. Let me just check that it's okay. It's pretty clean. I'm going to blend that out. Actually, I have one more green eyeshadow. That was a lie. I know where my other green eyeshadow is. So it's in the Androgyny palette by Jeffree Star. This palette is freaking awesome. Okay, and it is the color Military. So I'm going to work that into like this outer area. Just to make it like a little bit of a lighter kind of smoke thing. I've never used this color before, so I don't know how well it's going to go. And I am aware that I'm going like in almost the exact same direction at the start where I am with my pink one. But I promise you it's going to get worse also because I look like I've been punched, but that's my point. I'm going to take Dominatrix now and chuck that on my lid as a base for a darker color just while I am in the Androgyny palette. Okay, I'm gonna take this Too Faced all over shadow brush and just pop Dominatrix on my lids. And then I'm going to take Military again, and I'm just gonna blend that in with Dominatrix and kind of keep working that up so it's like a really sickly green. I really like greens. Green is one of my favorite colors, especially like really, really true green. It's so awesome, especially for like Halloween. It's a party and a half. It's really freaking cool. Okay, I'm gonna take another darker brown. This is from the Lime Crime Venus palette, and it is the color Icon. I use this a lot when I do smoky eyes, especially like orangey ones, where I just pack a whole lot of black on my lid and smoke it out using orange. I'm gonna take this little MAC brush. It is a 239 SE, and I'm going to take Icon and pack it on my eyelid. I just really want to have like a dark lid. And the mirror in this palette is terrible, which it might be because I've had it for like 2 years. And then just to get rid of the harshness of the transition between the brown and the greens, I'm going to take the blending brush again and go in with Military yet again. And I'm just going to mix those together using Military. I really like that. Heck! Okay, so I'm going to do eyeliner now. Oh, my light died. That's super fun. I'm going to be using trusty old Kat Von D tattoo one, and I'm just going to do a really standard wing. Oh, hell yeah. That looks even. Okay, cool. So I'm going to do my other eye off camera, and I will be back with you in 2 seconds. Okay, the eyeliner is like proper uneven. You should be right. This is the completed eye look. I actually messed up. I forgot to use Venus Flytrap as a liner, which is what I originally planned to do. So I tried to like kind of make a little line there, but I didn't do it with the right brush and I messed up real bad and I had to wipe it off with a makeup wipe. So I've got a little patch there. So if you notice that, like Saws X, I don't know. I don't know what to do. I'm just going to go over some areas with cream and I'm just going to be diving back into the Makeup Forever Flash Color Palette, and I'm going to be mainly using the green and the brown and maybe a little bit of the red. Don't know what I'm doing. So I'm going to go like a little bit around my forehead with that green. I'm going to do something a little daring. I don't know how well this is going to pay off. I'm actually going to take Military again. And I'm going to go over the cheekbones with that colour. Okay, I'm going to take this Chi-Chi brush. It is an angled blush. And it is number 126, apparently. So I'm just going to... I can't tell if there's anything on there, but like... Oh, that's definitely something. I'm going to take my powder brush. Like that. I just want to make it a little bit less harsh at the front. That's not bad. Okay, I'm going to actually take Military onto my jaw as well, just to make it a little bit more even. And by putting like a giant brush in here, you're obviously going to get a fair bit of glare. I actually want to get heaps of videos out in October because I love Halloween. Like, it's my favorite holiday ever. I wait all year for Halloween and it just makes me so happy. I love it. Okay, so it's a little patchy on the cheek, but we're working on it. And then again, I'm just going to blend the little harsh green dots that I put on before. And I'm just kind of like, I can't even speak English. I actually just kind of like patted those a little bit because I've got a little bit of fallout from Icon onto the dark circle areas. Being like, that happened. So I'll fix that in a second. But life lesson, have the excess of your eyeshadows. So, you know, there's a valuable lesson that you can take away from this. You don't need school, just... Sugar at. Oh, I just knocked fetish. Boy! And then that's me contouring with green. Done and dusted. So now I'm going to use some highlight and I'm going in with the Alchemist palette again because I really love the duochromes that they have in this. And I have Mint Condition by Jeffree Star, but I think it's going to be a little bit too blue-based for this look. So I'm going to be using the Emerald shade, which is this first one here. I'm going to take my regular little highlighting brush that I use for my inner corners and my brow burns, which is this one. It is the MAC 221 SE. And I'm just going to go in my inner corners and on my brow burn with that. That was literally my highlighting, like, done. I might put a little bit on my nose. I'm gonna do that with my finger. I'm literally just going like this. Oh, a good nose highlight really does it for me. Rudolph the Green Nose Reindeer. Okay, so I'm going to go back in with that Flash Colors palette and I'm just going to fix up the dark circles under my eyes, like the green ones. So I'm taking the green again and just kind of like patting it there. So just to finish the eyes off, I'm going to take Military again on this little Morphe brush. I don't know what kind of brush this is, but I'm just going to smoke it on my lower lash line. Hell yeah! I'm going to put lashes on now. So these lashes are my favourite ones. They fit my eyes really well because I have kind of small eyes. So they are the Flutter Lashes collaboration with Makeup Shayla in hashtag I slay. And they discontinued these a little while ago. And Morphe stopped stocking them, like they stopped stocking Flutter Lashes, so I don't know what I'm gonna do now. Gotta find another pair of lashes that I like. So I'm really bad at putting lashes on, so I'm gonna scoot my mirror a little closer to me. Oh, that fixed my lighting really nicely. Also, my hair is a mess, but like, I'm gonna take these tweezers that I use for everything, like I pluck my eyebrows with them, hold my lashes with them, like, what a time to be alive. There is so much leftover glue on these, it's disgusting. I think I might need to clean the leftover glue for them. Okay, this is my left lash. Praying. Genuinely, like, praying that this goes well. So I can't see anything because I'm supposed to wear glasses and I'm getting contacts soon, hopefully. This is going to be a struggle and a half. So I'm just going to take this lash glue, it's the Brush On Duo. Do it all the way here. I really like to smother the front bit of it in glue. It goes blue. Once you put it on, so yeah. How much is on each area? and all that super fun stuff. So my hands are shaking really badly. So I'm just gonna wait until that gets a little bit tacky, and I can't see anything. I'm going to guess that I can pop it on there. I'm not really like one for lashes, but when it comes to it, they're super fun to wear. So I'm actually going to take my roller lash just to kind of set those two together. Oh, it's so heavy on my eyes. I did one lash successfully. Let's see if I can do another one. That should be enough glue off. So I'm gonna take it in tweezers again, say a prayer, brush the gel on again, and make sure to really, really, really focus it on the corner of this one, because this one always pops off, because me and my right side don't get along very well. We're not the best of mates. Me and my left side, you know, been around for a while, but my right side and I, just like acquaintances. Okay! So I'm waiting for that to get a little bit tacky. And didn't turn out too bad. So I'm gonna wait a little bit for that one to set before I put the mascara on it, because I'm scared if I do, it'll just come flying off. Woohoo! I have long eyelashes, madam. Yeah. So I'm gonna try. I feel like I have birds on my bird wings as eyelashes now. Okay, so that is my eyelashes done. So that leaves only one more thing to go, and that is lipstick. So today I'm going to be using Crocodile Tears by Jeffree Star. Is my favorite lipstick ever, other than Sugar Pill Trinket. But this is my favorite, like, crazy colored lipstick. I love green, and I'm just obsessed with this color. Yeah, I'm just gonna put that on my lips now. I really like this, actually, like a little glamorous zombie. I'm just waiting for this to dry, and I'm going actually to take Dirty Money, and I'm going to put that in the center of my lip, and I'm going to blend it out with my finger. It just hit me. I have eyelashes on that aren't mine. So I'm going to take the moon... I just hit it. I'm gonna take the Moondust palette, which is like pressed glitter shadows. I'm gonna take the color Lightyear, which is green, and I'm going to put that on the sides of my lips. I know I'm taking this off like 2 seconds after, but I'm going to use setting spray anyway. It is the Kat Von D Locket setting spray, and I like this a lot, so I bought it because I have no self-control. And I'm going to spray it like this in my face. I can't close my eyes with these lashes on. Closing my eyes just hurt so badly with these lashes. This is the finished look of the green episode of the Crayola series, and I am very happy with how this turned out. I genuinely can't stop blinking because I'm so confused. There's a foreign object in my eye. I just like this. I thought it was a nice warm up to all of the Halloween videos I'm going to be uploading, because I freaking love Halloween. Really, really hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'm going to continue with my regular outro if I remember it. So, as always, remember to feel free to steeze me a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed seeing my head being turned green, and if you enjoyed hearing my voice, all of my socials are linked down below. My regular Instagram is at doshprincess, give it a follow, and my makeup Instagram is at charlydidthis, give that a follow too. I crave attention and validation and like social blade. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. I'm definitely gonna be uploading a lot more soon. I'm going to be talking more about like the world and conspiracy theories and all that fun stuff, as opposed to constantly doing makeup tutorials. But thank you guys for sticking around. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for liking, and thank you for watching. And I will catch you guys later.